Marcus to Dietrich, when you're close to the target, please report the degrees in your bomb sight.
At the moment, we don't have a target. The raid's just been shot down by flak. At the moment, I'm floating in the Thames River. I'm waiting for the Kriegsmarine to send a U-boat out to come and pick me up. And then we've got a special operations mission. This one is to rescue some air crews from JU-88s that have been shot down in the London area. It's going to be pretty tough. We're going to have to get ourselves past the estuary defences and actually get into the Thames River itself. Not going to be easy. Okay, I'm spawning in again. Okay, we have a long mission this time. We've got a very long flight out, which will allow us to climb quite high to get out of reach of the flak, and then we're going to go in over London at around dusk, and so that way we can use the cover of darkness. As long as we don't run into any high altitude fighters, we should be fine.
Spitfire 6 o'clock high.
Bandits.
Yeah, I wonder who that could be. Yeah, that'll be Dixon all right. At the moment, he's lurking on the edge of space. So far away, we can't see him. Then he'll come screaming down and go racing past us so quickly we won't be able to shoot him. And then he'll go and land at his airbase, and he'll be home in time for tea. Or a dinner date at the Naffy van, one of the two. Problem is that we can't shoot him as he goes past, he'll be going too fast, and we can't see him when he's so high up. Well, not without a telescope. And the only telescope on a JU-88 is the Lautfair bombsight, and that points straight down. Hang on a second. Wait a moment. I think I've got an idea. This is Bomber Flight Leader 17th Formation. Bomber Leader is going to break away from the main group. Terminal wants you to take over and take the main formation in at altitude.
What height?
Keep it at 5.5 to 6 kilometers. Hardigan, I want you to follow me in your 110, provide close cover.
Diktat.
Okay, so if I can get this JU-88 flipped upside down, that means I can use the lower gunner to fire straight up and get Dixon. I'm going to have to use the Lautfair bombsight to sight this, and it's going to be pretty risky. Hardigan, keep it covered.
Diktat, on course.
It's now upside down.
Okay.
Now, where's Dixon? Now, I think I might have a problem here. My lower gunner's not used to being the right way up. He's now thrown up. Well, that's that plan out of action. I'm gonna have to come up with something else. Now that's a good thing we've got Keller as Hardigan's rear gunner. New flight plan coming up, Hardigan. Keller, get ready for firing.
Victor.
Victor.
Got him. There's Dixon. Yep, with two others. Yep, high above. I've got a lock on him.
Understood.
Now, if I can just keep him locked in the center of the crosshairs.
What I want you to do is get in as close as you possibly can and line up exactly with my JU-88. Is that understood?
Understanding.
Okay, just stand by any moment now. Okay, get your rear gunner ready to fire. And on my command, fire. Okay, fire.
Help me fire.
Yes! Got him! Okay, thanks, Keller. You can stop firing now. Seriously, stop firing. Oh, and it looks like without their leader, the other two Spitfires are turning away. Yes, the other two Spitfires are heading back. Yep, the raid is clear. We can proceed to London.
Excellent.
Okay, I'm turning around. I'm going to head back to France. Carry on, meet up the rest of Bomber Flight. See you back at base.
Nico.
So, the raid made it to London and back, and we shot down Dixon. Of course, we didn't kill him. Dixon has 9 lives, or perhaps 19. But by the time he's floated down from that altitude, he will have missed his dinner date at the nappy van. Someone's not going to be happy. Anyway, all's well that ends well. Great flying, Hardigan. Good shooting, Keller.
I'm waiting for the check in the post.
Ha! Well, at least our postal service works, unlike the British one. Which reminds me. Postman Pat, Postman Pat, Postman Pat, and his black and white cat.